But the broader issue here is we can't escape talking about the energy market if we're not going to talk about the fundamental causes of the skyrocketing prices, which has been $3 billion a year being provided to renewable energy generation, which has pushed out the use of coal plants. And we see South Australia has the highest energy prices in the world. And and these prices are increasing right across the country. We have over 1,000 years worth of coal. And so the government should be looking at abolishing the renewable energy target, withdrawing from the Paris Climate Agreement, and ruling out any clean energy target and allowing the free and fair operation of the market so it responds to the long-term interests of consumers and businesses rather than the short-term interests of lobbyists and politicians.
And Ben Oakwood, I suspect that you'd come back at Daniel Wildwolf by saying, well, if that's the case, then it's not surprising that the Commonwealth Bank should have joined the other major banks in saying they won't underwrite the Adani coal mine in central Queensland, and nor should the government be providing, or the taxpayer be providing, any sort of subsidy to get that off the ground.
Well, at least Daniel and I will agree that the idea of giving a $1 billion loan to fund coal infrastructure in Queensland for Adani would be a complete disaster. So we can set that one aside.
Is Ben right there, by the way, too?
Absolutely, absolutely. And I'm glad that I wait to hear Ben advocating for abolishing the $3 billion in subsidies for renewables.
And what do you say to that?
Well, Daniel, you support
nah,
industries that you want to flourish, and industries that are causing pollution and damage you don't support.